Greetings and salutations. This is JTR Raps, and on this week's True Pro Wrestling Story, we have an ex-professional wrestler named Andre Davis, an HIV-positive man whose dreams of being a WWE superstar went up in smoke after a physical revealed that he was carrying the virus. Davis was a ladies' man. His in-ring monikers, Andre Hart, the Gangsta of Love, and Sweet Sexy Sensation. Ohio state law requires those who are infected with the disease to disclose their positive HIV status to their partners prior to any sexual contact whatsoever. So, what did Andre Davis do? Let's wrap. So HIV was widely unknown back in the 80s, and signs and symptoms weren't immediate nor noticeable. And a common misconception about HIV positive people was that it was only a gay man's disease. If you're a straight man, then you don't have to worry about getting affected by it. Now, while it's true that gay and bisexual young people of color have the highest rates, especially African Americans, it's a much more manageable condition nowadays. The life expectancy in the 1980s wasn't so good and was measured in weeks and months. We didn't know how to treat this new pandemic. So according to HIV.gov, there are approximately 1.2 million people in the U.S. living with HIV today, and about 14% don't know it and need testing. It's a well-known fact that if left untreated, HIV typically turns to AIDS in 8 to 10 years, and once that happens, you know, the virus attacks your immune system and the risk of other infections increase tenfold. It is potentially, to this day, still a deadly disease. Imagine the 14% who don't know that they're carrying it and they become infected with COVID-19. It could ultimately turn into a death sentence. HIV can still be transmitted by coming into direct contact with body fluids from a person with HIV. Blood, semen, vaginal, rectal fluids, breast milk, and childbirth. Make no mistake about it, HIV is a biological weapon. Why? Because it is a virus, and if the person carrying it is irresponsible with the disease, it can transmit the disease and cause death. Speaking of irresponsibility, let's talk about Mr. Andre Davis, a former independent professional wrestler who wrestled by his in-ring name, Andre Hart, the Gangsta of Love. Andre Davis was born on the 7th of January, 1982 in Daytona Beach, Florida, the city of wide open fun. He attended pro wrestling training in Cincinnati, Ohio from Les Thatcher, who is an esteemed former professional wrestler whose most notable accomplishments include winning the National Wrestling Alliance World Tag Team Championship with a wrestler by the name of Dennis Hall. And he was also the first ever inductee to the Smoky Mountain Wrestling Hall of Fame in 1994. Andre Davis subsequently debuted in the year 2004 at the Heartland Wrestling Association, an independent promotion founded by Les Thatcher, which has produced some of the industry's biggest and brightest talents, the likes of Jon Moxley, D'Lo Brown, Matt Stryker, Sami Callihan, and Nigel McGuinness. The HWA produced a one-hour weekly TV show called HWA Adrenaline, which Davis performed. He wrestled singles, but the accolades he achieved were with tag team partners. He is a three-time HWA tag team champion. Now, while Davis may have been a stud in the ring, he was a dud in his dating life, which we'll get to. Andre Davis' lifelong dream was to be a professional wrestler in hopes of one day performing for the global conglomerate and be all in all in the world of sports entertainment, WWE. Now, it's my assumption that Mr. Davis began his superstar journey by attending a tryout offered by WWE with credentials in hand and desire in his heart. No pun intended. A WWE tryout is taxing. Athletes are expected to come prepared and perform a lot of physical, exhausting movements and drills. You have prospects who are the most diverse athletes and entertainers from all over the world competing, yes, competing for a shot at a developmental contract. And make no mistake about it, the fact that the competition is fierce, a particular class of talent may already have experienced in-ring workers. as well as international talent, and you've got to outwork your fellow recruits, right? So you've got to hand your heart to God and leave the rest in the ring, straight up. But let's say you pull that off. Just like any other job, you've got to present your resume, be interviewed, fill out an application, and pass a physical given by a physician. This is the part where Andre Davis does not pass go, nor collect $200 because the results were in. He was revealed to be HIV positive. Now, I can only imagine that Andre Davis's heart skipped a couple beats as his diagnosis was read. In his mind, that's his world, and now it's crumbling all around him. My dream was to be a WWE superstar. What do I do? My sex life is over. What about my family? What will my family think? You know, there's still a negative perception associated with having HIV. People living with it who have openly and honestly disclosed their HIV status with their partners, family members, have been subject to rejection and hurtful reactions. There's still a stigma about it with those who may not be educated on its progression, right? Especially in 2021. Some emotions that come to mind that a person might be met with: fear, shock, disgust, sadness, disappointment, and anger, especially anger. Here's a thought. Suppose you do tell your significant other in confidence. What's to say they're not going to betray your trust and tell someone else, and they then tell someone, and shit keeps rolling downhill. Now your HIV is being used as a malicious gossip. So, fearing the worst of social outcomes, Davis made a conscious decision to conceal the results of his HIV test, and his love life continued on. I say again, Ohio's HIV disclosure laws state that those persons who are infected with this disease disclose their positive HIV status to their partners prior to any sexual contact, and also must disclose their HIV status to anyone with whom they share a hypodermic needle. Point blank, period. He betrayed the trust of these women with whom he has sexual relations. And look, you know in your heart of hearts when you're wrong. You know. What if it were you? What if you were offered a job and this potential job requires that you obtain a physical if health and/or fitness is indeed a job requirement? Now, in my experience, if you don't hear anything from your physician, you're good to go, right? Well, the doctor's ringing, and unbeknownst to you, he or she is bearing bad news. You're asked to come in for a follow-on visit. Sir or ma'am, I regret to inform you that the results of your HIV test return a positive reading. You have HIV. Are you presently in a relationship? How many partners have you had or are you having sexual relations with? Sir, ma'am, I understand this must sound devastating, but advances in medicine have brought us a long way in managing the virus. Today, you can live your life comfortably, perhaps for the next 50 years. Does this make your situation better? Depends on how you look at it, but nonetheless, you were just informed that you have HIV. After the initial shock begins to subside, then what? How did I get it? Who gave it to me? Or, Daryl's the only one I've had sex with. Now you're angry, depressed, feelings of distaste and animosity come over you, right? The walls just came tumbling down all around you like Jericho, and this person just ruined my life. So what do you do? What about the bastard who knew he had it and didn't say anything to you? You trusted this person. Or maybe you didn't. Maybe it was just a fling, right? And you were really feeling this person and you decided not to use protection. Now you're putting the blame on yourself, and who knows what that can lead to. Should my person who violated me go to jail, or does this call for some vigilante justice? Anything happened at this stage? Now, while Andre Davis must have thought about it, he failed to do the right thing by having unprotected sex with 12 women and not telling them he was HIV positive. Therefore, he had 12 chances or more to either be upfront about it or come clean. Reportedly, it was the mother of Davis's two children who stumbled upon his test results, and received a text reply from Davis confirming his HIV-positive status, which she would later testify to in court. When asked about her reaction to Davis's text, she was, and I quote, shocked. I didn't know what to do, end quote. She decided to share that information with women he was sexually involved with. She told another and another, and charges were pressed. Andre Davis was charged with 15 counts of felonious assault, a second-degree felony, which can potentially land you behind bars anywhere between 2 to 8 years for his activities after hours.
Way now for a former professional wrestler charged with not telling a dozen sex partners that he is HIV positive. Andre Davis of Hyde Park faces 15 felony assault charges. Ohio law requires people who know they are HIV positive to disclose their status to potential partners. This is file video of his arraignment. We do have a crew in the courtroom where jury selection began this morning. We'll resume at 1:15, and at that time, attorneys on both sides will discuss Davis possibly pleading out. We'll bring you updates as they come into the newsroom.
The case went to trial in Hamilton County in Ohio, and Davis was convicted on all but one count. He was found not guilty on felonious assault and count two, as read by the judge during the verdict. Each count he was convicted of carried a hefty sentence, as mentioned earlier, and during sentencing, Hamilton County Judge Jerome Metz sentenced Davis to 32 years.
Is a former wrestler to 32 years in prison for failing to tell multiple sexual partners he was HIV positive. 9 News reporter Shannon Kettler was in the courtroom. She joins us now from the newsroom with reaction. Shannon?
Well, Tanya, Andre Davis was facing a total of 112 years behind bars for failing to warn 11 sexual partners that he was HIV positive. Prosecutors said this is a case Hamilton County Court rarely sees because there are so many victims, 11 women just with this trial. Today, Davis read a statement before the court stating he was a sex addict and a narcissist. Davis was a wrestler who went by the name of Andre Hart, but his contract with a professional wrestling organization was rescinded after a physical showed he was HIV positive. Prosecutors said the father of five did not tell at least a dozen women that he was HIV positive. And Ohio law requires anyone who tests positive to reveal that information because HIV is a potentially deadly virus. Davis was convicted of 14 counts of assault and had this to say to the court before his sentence was handed down.
I've asked for forgiveness for the things I've done wrong. I pray that these women do not hate me, and I truly am sorry for my actions.
That wasn't all, because he faced similar charges in neighboring counties, Butler and Warren. He was subsequently sentenced to 30 additional months to be served concurrently with his 32-year sentence. Now, in a 4-page handwritten statement made by Davis in court just prior to sentencing, he claimed he was a sex addict who fell into a deep depression and spiraled out of control, his dream of becoming a WWE superstar having ended following the revelation of his HIV status. His coping mechanism: sleep with woman after woman after woman. And although he wasn't truthful about carrying the disease, he never intended to harm anyone. He said, and I quote, "I am not a monster," end quote. He also admitted to being scared to tell anyone because of how uneducated society is, and expressed wanting to take his own life. He pleaded with the court for the minimum sentence, saying he was intent on becoming a motivational speaker in efforts to educate others on the dangers of HIV, or words to that effect. The mother of Davis's two children spoke on his behalf as well, claiming Davis to be a changed man throughout the time they'd known each other, and asked the court for leniency in his sentence. However, with the weight of each of his victims' testimonies, to include the police detective who interviewed Davis during his arraignment, told the court that Davis not once ever appeared to be sorry or express any sort of remorse during questioning. It was a wrap for the Gangster of Love. Davis's attorney openly stated to the court that his client, Andre Davis, was a narcissistic person with bipolar disorder, but all in all, he never intended to hurt anyone. He also expressed that the women Davis slept with bore some of the responsibility for choosing to have unprotected sex, and he plans to appeal Davis' sentence. So what do you guys think of this case? Crazy, ain't it? 32 years plus 30 months in prison? I'm on the fence. That's a lengthy sentence, and to think that you actually have killers who may have deliberately murdered their victims who were handed similar sentences, I don't know. If he were to serve out the entirety of the sentence, he'd be, what, 60? He was 29 when he was convicted. Yes, he was convicted of felonious assault, which is obviously punishable by law, and you gotta take your charge. If he is genuinely sorry and wants to change for the better, everything that he intended on doing, being a motivational speaker and educating people on HIV, he can do all of that on the inside. Do your time, don't let your time do you. The problem though is that some people go into prison for nonviolent or small crimes and come out even bigger criminals and more violent than when they went in. So comment down below with your thoughts and opinions. You think he should have received such a lengthy sentence? What are your thoughts overall? How am I doing? Leave a like, subscribe, and I'll catch y'all on the next one. Until then, I'm out. Y'all stay safe.